This week, at Interior. Governors and delegates from the U.S. territories traveled to Washington, D.C. last week for a White House conference to discuss economic policy and development issues. Secretary Jewell hosted the event, with Assistant Secretary Kia Aina leading much of the group's discussion. A common thread in much of the conference's discussion, how to gain greater representation within the federal government. The event was webcast live on DOI.gov. Joining the governors and delegates were representatives from the Departments of Treasury, Commerce, and Homeland Security, the Small Business Administration, and the Western Pacific Regional Fishery Management Council. For folks working to get young people to America's public lands, the permitting process just got a little bit easier. Secretary Jewell issued a secretary's order this week to knock down barriers for disadvantaged and under-resourced youth to access America's public lands and waters through expediting the permit process. The latest step in the administration's efforts to foster the next generation of outdoor stewards, the action honors the legacy and recent passing of noted conservationist and philanthropist Douglas W. Walker, a champion of sharing the natural world with young people from all backgrounds. From kids in parks to kids in science, Lab Day at the U.S. Geological Survey. On Monday, the USGS welcomed students from Reston, Virginia's Langston Hughes Middle School, part of the White House's My Brother's Keeper Day at the Lab, and African American Heritage Month. Thousands of young people nationwide visited labs to learn about science, technology, engineering, and math opportunities, and to instill in them a passion for entrepreneurship and innovation. Students here toured the USGS Microbiology Lab to learn about microorganisms in the environment. They also visited the Groundwater Dating Lab, where they learned how scientists are working on methods to understand and manage the nation's water resources. Secretary Jewell on the road and across our southern border, working with Mexican representatives to strengthen cooperation on energy development, conservation, and preparation for the impacts of climate change. The Secretary and her counterparts at the Mexican Ministries of Energy and Environment and Natural Resources committed to increase safety and transparency through, among other things, discussion of common safety and environmental standards. A big meeting in Peru, the Extractive Industries Transparency Initiative. Representatives from Interior and the State Department met with their counterparts from nations across the world to discuss how to increase transparency and public engagement on the regulation of extractive industries. Natural resources, including a nation's oil, gas, metals, and minerals, belong to the people of that nation, and the Extractive Industries Transparency Initiative means to promote open and accountable management of those resources. Find out more at doi.gov/EITI. This year, March 3rd marked World Wildlife Day, with the theme, The Future of Wildlife is in Our Hands. You may recall Secretary Jewell's recent visit to Africa and the ongoing effort to stem the tide of poaching that is driving African elephants, rhinos, and other animals nearly to the point of extinction. Now, the U.S. Wildlife Trafficking Alliance is announcing significant private and nonprofit sector commitments to raise awareness, educate the buying public, and cut the demand at home for illegally traded wildlife parts. Find out more at uswta.org. March 3rd was also the 167th birthday of the U.S. Department of the Interior. Happy birthday. Here's to 167 more years serving the American public. And that's this birthday week at Interior.